mountain village. Yupik name is Asa'carsarmiut, means the beginning and the end of the hills. I made a choice to do the best I can to live off of the land, so it's almost every day I eat moose, I eat fish, and I eat birds. All kinds of fish, different kinds of birds, and one kind of moose.
I'm Agnes Brown. I was born in 1946 at Hooper Bay, and my family moved here to Mountain Village in 1949, and I've been here since. We did a lot of subsistence while I was growing up. They cut fish, they pick berries. My dad was a hunter, my brothers. But I love fish the most. Dried king salmon, the chinook, and the strips.
The homes are all built mostly in the 70s. We've had some new houses built that were designed in a tropical area. And were built up here in the north, where it gets down to negative 60 with wind chill.
This house is, I don't know, it's older than I am. It was downtown. And then I guess they were building themselves other house down there, and then they end up bringing this one up here and save this house and build another one down there. They brought it up on logs, and so long ago the logs are disintegrating, rotting away under there.
But they felt that my home was in such a bad shape that it was better that I have a new house. During the COVID. Well, it was basically that dripping that was really bad. The roof, because of it got so old, it shifted a lot, and it just dripped even during the winter time when it thawed out a little. But that's how I was able to be eligible for this home, and I'm so grateful.
We have molding issues, we have bad air quality issues. It's super expensive to keep the houses heated, and there is definitely overcrowding in at least half of the homes.
So in a community where most people are in some way related, either by family or by other ties, no one is going to be left on the corner or on the street, and there's of course no shelter. What that generally means is there's an invisible segment of a rural, remote community that is homeless and yet is staying with relatives or sleeping on living room floors.
There's just no housing. We don't know, I don't know where I'm gonna go. There's family here, it's just, everybody's staying with family or friends.
If on top of that, you live in a house that is inadequate for our physical environment, then you have the 1-2 punch of higher heating demand and higher cost per gallon of heating oil. And to the point where in much of rural Alaska, it's eating up all the money that you would use for other things. Not extra things, things like food, subsistence equipment that allows you to live the lifestyle that you want to live out there. The National Renewable Energy Laboratory's Alaska campus partnered with the tribe in Mountain Village to design affordable, healthy, energy-efficient housing specifically tailored to helping people transition out of homelessness. The key feature of these homes is that they are expandable. So if you move into the small version of the home, which is about 380 square foot, and you want to expand later, you have the freedom to expand, whether it be an entryway or an Arctic entryway, another bedroom.
Everything that was put into the homes created jobs out here and created or allowed our people to have actual job experience and learn more about the new science that we can put into homes that will benefit the people in a cold climate.
There are two things that make foundation design very difficult in Mountain Village. One is that the ground is frozen, and two, that it's thawing and no one knows how fast it will thaw. Our goal was to create a design of a foundation where, just like any other chore in spring cleaning, you go around the house and re-level the house quickly and efficiently. My hope for the house is that it aids the tribe and the people of Mountain Village to create housing that suits their needs, keeps people in the community, and allows for a quality life.